Now, I realize the importance of building a brand, and one of the main ways that you build a brand is consistency. But that said, I'm starting to feel like if you've seen one LEGO movie, you've seen them all. And that doesn't necessarily have to be a bad thing. I feel like we're at a crossroads here, because we have two types of consistency going on here, good and bad. On the good side, this is once again an enticing mix of childlike awe at the LEGO world building on display and genuine laughter at the surprisingly adult-friendly humor. Oh boy, did I laugh a lot at this movie, at least for the first third, before I got super bored. And that's the bad consistency. The LEGO movies, I think the first LEGO movie is the strongest, but you know, ever since then, weak finishes and even weak middles. And they're really only able to do the first act. So what you have here is all set up and no real playtime. If you've ever played with toys, and who hasn't, you know exactly what I'm talking about. And I appreciate a good setup. When I was little, my sister and I would take an entire day to set up our toys, and then we would play the whole next day. But this is all setup. But what a setup, though. And if the narrative writing was stronger, because the humor writing is on fire, this would be such an amazing movie. Seriously, it went from, it'd be hard for me to like this movie more. That's what I was thinking as the beginning of the first third unfolded. But then it went to, this must be for very small children. And I was ashamed that that was my reaction, because this is a side pet peeve of mine. Tangent. I really don't like it when people describe certain entertainment as for little kids. Like, it's so bad, but little kids don't know. Everybody knows something that's bad. It's universal. Really good entertainment is really good entertainment, no matter the target demographic. And I think that's just a way for people to not feel bad about parking kids in front of said content. So they're like, oh, the kid has to like it. It's got bright colors. Leave me alone. I need a break. So that's unfortunately what the second two-thirds of this movie are. But the beginning is so good. The beginning is so spectacular. I mean, if you're into genre filmmaking, or Legos, or both, you should really see this movie, even though the second and third acts are boring. There's like little gems hidden inside the second and third acts, but for the most part, I kind of found my mind wandering. And that's right, I'm recommending you pay full price, or at least matinee, to see a movie just for the first third of it. But the first third was so good. LEGO Ninjago starts out as a Valentine to martial arts cinema, complete with these amazingly themed title cards. Like, when the movie started, I was like, this came out of nowhere. I'm so excited. And once again, there's also a strong emphasis on the importance of play, which is, again, that's part of the good consistency of the LEGO movies. I like that. I think that's really nice to show that, you know, playing builds character and confidence and imagination, etc., thinking outside the box. That's really nice too. I like that element of these movies. And I don't want to give anything away, but the very, very opening of the movie was an unexpected, pleasant surprise, even if it didn't tonally match the entire rest of the movie. It was very jarring when they made the switch to the rest of the film. And I was like, as much as I appreciated that, you got a real tonality problem. All right, so the jokes, though. The jokes fly as fast and furious as the bricks. And they're fabulously absurd and very smart, very meta, my favorite kind of humor. I'd say the best way to describe it is the Austin Powers treatment for martial arts movies, and that's actually really spot on. Even with Garmadon being very Dr. Evil-y, which I thought was fantastic. I did find the movie a little disorienting, though, and to save yourself, I recommend that you forget everything you think you know about the LEGO Ninjago movie. And that's because a lot of the stuff from the trailer actually isn't in the movie. And in fact, to disorient you even more, there are lines from the trailer, but they're in different scenes with like different backdrops. So I was waiting for certain things, like favorite moments from the trailer. I was all so excited to see them, and then I was like, where's the scene? And sometimes it never showed up, and sometimes it happened again in a totally different part of the story in a totally different place. And that really freaked me out. I don't know why they did that. Although it made me start, also, I guess that made me check out of the movie a little bit as well. Although if it had me, this wouldn't have happened. But I was like, did they reanimate the entire sequence to go along with the dialogue they'd already recorded? Why would they do that? Was that much of a problem? Was this movie seriously reworked at the last minute? So that's where my mind started to wander. I also think the movie didn't need to have a team. I know that's kind of like the whole point of LEGO Ninjago, but there was so much to work with between Garmadon and Lloyd that every time they went to the team members, I was like, we don't have time for you. And only Kumail Nanjiani's voice stood out. Everybody else, like at the end credits, I was like, oh yeah, that's who was here. But, you know, they had so little to say that they didn't, like Fred Armisen, like, I hope he got some money because he had nothing to do. But I did decide that of all the elemental powers, I totally go with lightning. It looks cool. It allows you to levitate. That's right. I'm swept up in the lightning craze. And there's really just so much to like about this movie. It's funny. It's creative. It has a great message. It's touching. Surprisingly touching. Dave Franco and Justin Theroux are doing some real acting here. And it has a live cat. That's all fabulous. But it just gets kind of boring as it loses its way trying to be to be feature length. And I hope that they can crack this problem, because if they can't, I don't see LEGO movies lasting much longer. Maybe LEGOs really are only meant for a short form format, which would be a shame, because everybody does a really good job here, except for the writers, basically. Top-notch voice work, like top-notch. You don't get better voice work than in this movie. Exciting directing. Jaw-dropping world building, like really impressive builds. Wow. Flawless animation. Great music choices too. And if only the writers would step up to the plate. The jokes are good. Surprising twists are good. But none of it works if you don't have a solid three-act structure and you don't keep your audience engaged. It's really hard to turn a funny sketch, no matter how funny it is, into a feature-length movie. Just ask SNL. But it can be done, so I still am holding out hope for future LEGO movies. But again, I don't know how much longer my faith can last. How about yours? How do you feel about LEGO movies, the third one in? Write your thoughts down below, and as always, you can check out some more videos right now.